The next topic is short circuit. Several times we hear or read about a building catching fire due to short circuit. There are a number of accidents that happen, and we hear or read about a building or a cinema hall catching fire due to short circuit, and we even hear about a number of precious lives being lost. So sometimes if we switch on an equipment in our house, the electric fuse wire melts and the electric supply shuts down. So if we have fuse wires for various electrical appliances that function on high electric energy, like refrigerator, TV, or microwaves, etc., then we can avert such accidents, because we have just now seen the application of an electric fuse wire, how it is made out of a low melting point alloy of lead and tin. So even if excess current flows, the fuse wire melts and breaks the circuit and prevents the person as well as the equipment from damage, and it averts accidents like short circuit. So now let us understand what is this short circuit and how it takes place and how can we avoid it. The home electrical connection consists of live, neutral, and earth wires. Live wire is the positively charged wire, neutral one is the negatively charged wire, and earth wire refers to the earthing which is done. Now you must all have seen 3-pin plugs in your home. Out of that, one pin is for live, the other for neutral, and the third one is for earth. We generally have 3-pin plugs for those appliances which function on high electrical energy, or those appliances which draw more electric current. So TV, refrigerators, microwaves make use of 3-pin plug wires. The live and neutral wires have potential difference of 220 volts. So in India we have this potential difference between the live and neutral wire, which can be between 220 to 250 volts. Now you can understand that when we say live wire, that is positively charged wire, which is at a high electric potential, it is at 220 volts. Whereas neutral wire, which is the negatively charged one, is at low electric potential, and it is at zero potential. So one is at 220, the other is at zero. So this potential difference is constantly maintained, which causes the flow of electric current. The earth is connected to ground. So the earth wire, the third one in the 3-pin plug, is connected to the ground. Now, why we make use of the earthing wire, or why earthing is done? So many electrical appliances have got metallic body, like electric heater, toaster, oven, refrigerators, etc. And if by chance the insulation of the wires melt, it is possible that the live wire may touch the metallic body of the appliance. And we know that the live wire is at 220 volts. So this live wire, if it touches the metallic body of the appliance, and we are also directly handling these appliances, so if we touch this metallic body with bare hands, we may also receive a shock. To avoid such accidents, metal casings of all these electrical appliances are earthed. So in earthing, one end of the copper wire is connected to the metal case of the appliance, and the other end is connected to the copper plate, which is buried deep inside the earth. So this system of connecting the metal body of the electric appliance with a copper plate buried deep inside the earth is called as earthing. So if we have done the earthing, And if there is live wire that is has lost its insulation and it has come in direct contact with the metal body of the appliance and the current is flowing through it, and you are directly touching the appliance, all the current will flow through the earth wire and you will be saved from the shock. Similarly, if we make use of rubber slippers, hand gloves that are made out of rubber, or we stand on a wooden plank, we do not get an electric shock. Because wood or rubber acts as an insulator and the circuit of the current with the earth does not get completed through our body and we are saved from getting the shock. So that is the importance of earth wire, and that is why it is done, that is earthing is done. Now, due to fault in the equipment, or if the plastic coating of the live and the neutral wires gives way, the two wires come in contact with each other and large current flows through it producing heat. So sometimes it so happens that the appliance is very old, or due to some faulty connection, or the live and the neutral wire lose their insulations, the plastic coating which is over them, it may give way or it may break, and it so happens that the live and the neutral wire both come in contact with each other. Now we know what is the potential difference between the two. One is at 220, the other is at zero. So when two such wires come in contact with one another, the resistance of the circuit becomes very small and huge amount of current flows through it. Now you know the relation between resistance and current. They both are inversely proportional to one another. So if the resistance of the conductor drops, there will be very huge current that will be flowing. So this huge current that is flowing causes the wires to get heated up to a very high temperature and the entire circuit catches fire. So the two wires, they may come in contact with each other and large current flows through it producing heat. If any inflammable material such as wood, cloth, plastic, etc. exists around that place, it can catch fire. Therefore, a fuse wire is used as a precautionary measure. Now we realize that what is the importance of a fuse wire. If a fuse wire is installed, then due to its low melting point, it breaks the circuit by melting and it may prevent the accidents. As soon as high current flows in the circuit, the fuse wire melts and breaks the circuit and any mishap is avoided. So this is what is short circuiting. That is, live and neutral wire come in direct contact or touch each other and short circuit takes place and the resistance of the entire circuit falls down, thereby increasing lot of current to flow through it, causing the wires to get heated up to the extent that they catch fire. And any inflammable material, that is any material that can burn easily, like wood, cloth, plastic, is present around, it may also catch fire and result in a fire breaking out and it may be fatal. So I hope you have understood what is short circuit. And with this, we come to the end of the heating effect of electric current. The next topic that we will be studying is the magnetic effect of electric current. So we will begin with the new topic in the next class. Thank you.